From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. A young girl's in serious condition after a tree fell on her family's tent and pinned her inside. The family was camping at Flat Rock Bridge Resort in Lebanon when a thunderstorm brought 60-mile-per-hour wind gusts knocking down trees. Around 6 Monday evening, one of the large trees fell 40 feet on top of the family's campsite. Lebanon fire and rescue crews were able to save the girl from the debris. Family friends say her name is Emily Malowitz, and officials say she is expected to make a full recovery. The other family members suffered minor injuries. Those camping next to the family say the experience was traumatic.
Four children, they're quadruplets, all age 10, and three of them were out of the tent, and they were screaming, and one of the daughters was still in the tent, and the father was holding it just at the tree, and we were just screaming for people to come and help lift the tree off.
The National Weather Service says it was straight-line winds, not a tornado, that caused the damage in Lebanon. A state representative from Scarborough is charged with operating under the influence following a crash on Interstate 295 over the weekend. Maine State Police say 25-year-old Sean Flaherty crashed his car on the highway just before 2 in the morning on Sunday in Freeport. Police say Flaherty told them that he swerved to miss an animal, bounced off a guardrail, lost control, went off the road, and then flipped his car. The car, as you can see, was totaled. Police say Flaherty did not want to be taken to the hospital. He was released from the Cumberland County Jail after posting bail. The city of South Portland is getting creative to try and deal with a tight budget and lower its electric bills. South Portland city officials have pitched the idea of creating a nonprofit electricity supply company, which would allow South Portland to buy power at wholesale prices. The assistant city manager says it would be the first arrangement of its kind in the state. The plan would save the city between 10% and 20% on its bills, and eventually residents and businesses may be able to take advantage of the lower prices too.
If I can't do anything about the effect of property tax or other state taxes, then at least what we can do is deal with the cost of energy, which should be more make the community more attractive for businesses that want to grow and expand.
If the city council signs off on the plan, it could be in place before 2012. The state says it will now step up milfoil inspections on the Songo River, which links Sebago Lake to Brandy Pond and Long Lake. Beginning this week, all boats headed upstream from the lower Songo River through the lock will be inspected for milfoil. The Lakes Environmental Association will use both volunteer and paid boat inspectors funded by the Department of Environmental Protection. The Department of Conservation says it hopes these changes will address the milfoil problem without closing the lock. A Shapley woman is resting comfortably after her husband helped deliver their 7-pound, 9-ounce baby boy in a pickup truck on the side of a busy state highway. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.